The Wizard of Oz. Dorothy lived with her Aunt Em and Uncle Henry on a small farm in Kansas. Dorothy had only one friend, her dog, Toto. One day, while Dorothy and Toto were playing, they heard the awful sound of a storm. Uncle Henry stopped working and shouted, "There's a cyclone coming! Run for the cellar!" Toto ran into the house and hid under the bed. Dorothy followed him into the house. Then, a strange thing happened. The house turned around and around. Then it rose into the air. Hours passed. The house tossed and turned in the storm. Finally, Dorothy closed her eyes and fell asleep. After a long time, Dorothy woke up. She ran to the door and looked out at a magical land. Suddenly, she heard a small voice say,
"Welcome to the land of the Munchkins."
Dorothy turned around, and there were three men and one woman standing in a circle. They were all the same size as Dorothy, but they looked like grown-ups.
"How can we thank you for killing the Wicked Witch of the East? You have set us free."
"There must be some mistake," she said. "I haven't killed anyone." The tiny woman pointed to the house.
"Look, your house landed on the witch. There are her feet sticking out from under a block of wood."
"Oh, dear," cried Dorothy. "I'm so sorry."
"She was a very wicked witch, and she made the Munchkin slaves for many years. Now, thanks to you, we are free."
"Are you a Munchkin?" asked Dorothy.
"No,"
answered the woman.
"I am the Good Witch of the North."
Dorothy had never heard of a good witch, but the kind woman explained that Dorothy was now in the Land of Oz. In the Land of Oz, there were four witches. The witches who lived in the North and South were good witches, but the witches who lived in the East and West were wicked.
"Now you have killed the Wicked Witch of the East," exclaimed the woman.
Dorothy wanted to return to Kansas and see her Uncle Henry and Aunt Em.
"You must go to the Emerald City. Maybe the Wizard of Oz can help you," said the Good Witch.
"Who is the Wizard of Oz?" asked Dorothy.
"He is a great wizard,"
answered the Good Witch.
"How can I get to the Emerald City?" said Dorothy.
"You must walk,"
answered the Good Witch.
"You will see a yellow brick road. Follow that road and you will find the Wizard of Oz."
Then the Good Witch kissed Dorothy on the forehead. It was a magical kiss. It would protect Dorothy on her long trip. The Munchkins gave Dorothy the silver slippers that the Wicked Witch of the East had worn. They had a special magic, but no one knew what it was. Dorothy put on the silver slippers, waved goodbye to her new friends, and she and Toto began their journey to the Emerald City. Dorothy and Toto followed the yellow brick road for many miles. After a while, they stopped beside a big cornfield and sat down to rest. Not too far away, Dorothy could see a scarecrow. While Dorothy was looking at the scarecrow, she was surprised to see one of the eyes slowly wink at her. Dorothy walked up to the scarecrow.
"Good day," said the scarecrow.
"Did you speak?" asked Dorothy.
"Certainly,"
answered the scarecrow.
"How do you do?"
"I'm pretty well, thank you," replied Dorothy. "How are you?"
"I'm not feeling well," said the scarecrow. "This pole is stuck up my back and I can't get down."
Dorothy reached up and lifted the figure off the pole.
"Thank you very much," said the scarecrow. "Who are you and where are you going?" asked the scarecrow.
"My name is Dorothy," she said, "and I'm going to the Emerald City to ask the Great Oz to send me back to Kansas."
"Do you think," he asked, "that if I go to the Emerald City with you, the Great Oz will give me some brains?"
"I cannot tell," she answered, "but you may come with me if you like." The scarecrow joined Dorothy and Toto on their journey to the Emerald City. Soon, the daylight faded away and the sky grew very dark. After a little while, the scarecrow stopped.
"I see a cottage. Shall we go there?"
"Oh, yes," answered Dorothy. When they reached the cottage, Dorothy fell fast asleep. As the sun came up, Dorothy was wakened by an awful groan. Standing beside a large tree was a man made completely of tin. He held an axe in his hand. Dorothy looked at him in amazement. "Did you groan?" she asked.
"Yes,"
answered the tin man.
"What can I do for you?" asked Dorothy.
"Get an oil can and oil my joints," answered the tin man.
Dorothy ran back to the cottage and found an oil can. In just a few minutes, the tin man was able to move.
"How can I ever thank you?" he said. "How did you happen to be here?"
Dorothy explained that she, Toto, and the Scarecrow were all on their way to the Emerald City to see the Great Oz.
"Do you suppose Oz could give me a heart?" he asked. The Wicked Witch of the East cast an evil spell on me as I was out here chopping wood. She turned me into tin and took away my heart.
Why, I think so, she answered. So the Tin Man picked up his axe and his oil can and joined his new friends on their journey to Oz. As Dorothy and her friends continued on their way through the forest, they heard a terrible roar. A great lion ran onto the road. Dorothy and her two friends were very frightened, but little Toto ran ahead and barked at the huge beast. When the lion saw the little dog, he opened up his mouth as if to bite him. Dorothy became so angry at this that she rushed forward and slapped the lion on the nose. "Don't you dare bite Toto," she shouted.
"I didn't bite him," said the lion.
"No, but you tried to," Dorothy answered. "You're nothing but a coward."
The lion hung his head in shame.
"If I only had courage, then I could truly be the king of the beasts."
So, Dorothy, the Scarecrow, and the Tin Man invited the lion to join them on their journey to the Emerald City. After several days, they saw a large field of poppies. When there are that many of them together, the smell is so powerful that anyone who breathes it falls asleep. Dorothy did not know this, and in a very short time her eyes grew heavy and she sat down to rest. The Tin Man tried to awaken Dorothy, but Dorothy was fast asleep.
"What shall we do?"
asked the Tin Man. The Scarecrow had an idea. He told the lion to run quickly through the field so that he could escape the deadly flowers. Then he and the Tin Man could carry Dorothy and Toto out of the poppy field. After a while, they came to a bend in the river. There, lying fast asleep in the flowers, was the lion. The smell from the poppies had been so strong that the huge beast had given up and fallen asleep. The Scarecrow and the Tin Man felt very sad. Since they could not carry the lion because he was so heavy, they had no choice but to leave him there to sleep. The next morning, Dorothy and her friends started on their way. Soon, they saw a beautiful green glow in the sky. "That must be the Emerald City," said Dorothy. Finally, they reached the end of the yellow brick road. Before them stood a huge gate, covered with emeralds. Next to the gate was a bell. Dorothy rang the bell, and the big gate swung open. A little man stood inside the room. He was dressed all in green. At his side was a large green box. He asked Dorothy and her friends why they had come to the Emerald City.
"We came here to see the Wizard of Oz," said Dorothy.
"It has been many years since anyone has come to see the Great Wizard," he said.
The small man explained that he was the guardian of the gate, and only he could take them through the Great Oz. But before they could enter, everyone had to put on green glasses. Dorothy and her friends were dazzled by the wonderful city. The streets were lined with beautiful houses, which were all made of green marble and covered with sparkling emeralds. There were many people all dressed in green clothing. Several shops were open, and Dorothy saw that everything in them was green. The guardian of the gate led them through the streets until they came to a big building, exactly in the middle of the city. This was the Palace of Oz. In front of the door stood a soldier.
"Here are the strangers," said the guardian of the gate, "and they demand to see the Great Oz."
The soldier asked everyone to follow him inside the palace. Then he asked them to wait while he brought their message to the Great Oz. They had to wait a long time. When he finally came back, Dorothy asked, "Have you seen Oz?"
"Oh, no," answered the soldier. "I have never seen him, but I spoke to him. I gave him your message. He said that he will talk to each one of you, but he will see only one of you each day, so you must stay here at the palace for a few days. I will show you to your rooms."
The next morning, a young woman dressed all in green came to see Dorothy. She gave Dorothy a lovely green dress and even tied a green bow around Toto's neck. Then the woman led Dorothy and Toto to the throne room of the palace to see the Great Oz himself. The room was very big, and all the walls were covered with glistening emeralds. In the middle of the room stood a huge throne. In the center of the chair was an enormous head.
"I am Oz, the great and terrible. Who are you, and why are you here?"
I am Dorothy, and I have come to ask you to help me return to my home in Kansas.
Where did you get those silver shoes, and what is that mark on your forehead?"
Dorothy explained that the shoes had belonged to the Wicked Witch of the East, and that the mark on her forehead was the magical kiss of the Good Witch of the North.
"If you want me to help you return to Kansas, you must first kill the Wicked Witch of the West."
"I have never killed anything," she explained.
But the Great Oz only said,
That is my answer. Until the Wicked Witch dies, you will not return to Kansas.
Sadly, Dorothy left the throne room and told her friends what had happened. The next morning, the soldier led the Scarecrow into the throne room. There, sitting on the sparkling throne, was a beautiful woman dressed in green. Large green wings grew from her shoulders.
I am the Great Oz. Who are you, and what do you want?
The Scarecrow was very surprised. He had expected to see the head Dorothy had told him about. But he answered the Great Oz and explained that what he wanted more than anything else was to have brains.
I never grant favors without something in return. If you will kill the Wicked Witch of the West, I will give you the best brains in all the land.
But you asked Dorothy to kill the Wicked Witch of the West, he said.
So I did, answered Oz. I don't care who kills her, but until she is dead, I will not grant your wish.
The Scarecrow returned to his friends. He told them that the Great Oz had appeared in the form of a beautiful woman, but had refused to give him any brains until the Wicked Witch was killed. The next morning, the Tin Man was called into the throne room. This time, the Great Oz appeared as a terrible beast.
I am Oz, the great and terrible, spoke the beast. Who are you, and what do you want?
The Tin Man explained that he wanted a heart. Oz explained to the Tin Man that he would receive a wonderful heart if only he helped Dorothy and the Scarecrow kill the Wicked Witch of the West. Tin Man left the throne room. When he returned to his friends, he told them what Oz had said. The next morning, it was the Lion's turn to talk to the Great Oz. When he entered the throne room, he saw a great ball of fire.
I am Oz, the great and terrible. Who are you, and what do you want?
I am a cowardly lion. I came to beg you to give me courage so that I can become the king of the beasts.
Bring me proof that the Wicked Witch is dead, and then I will give you courage.
The lion ran from the room and joined his friends. After the lion told Dorothy what had happened, she looked at him sadly.
What shall we do now? She asked.
There is only one thing we can do, answered the lion. And that is go to the land of the Winkies, where the Wicked Witch lives, and destroy her.
Dorothy and her friends were led to the gates of the Emerald City. After they had said goodbye to the guardian of the gate, they began to walk towards the west. Soon, Dorothy and the lion laid down on the cool grass and fell asleep. The Wicked Witch of the West was watching them. She had only one eye, but it was as powerful as a telescope, and she could see everything. The Wicked Witch was angry to find them in her country. She blew on a silver whistle. In a few seconds, a pack of wolves came running to her.
Go to those people, said the witch, and tear them to pieces.
The Scarecrow and the Tin Man heard the wolves coming. The Tin Man grabbed his axe, swung his arm, and chopped off the wolf's head. As soon as each wolf came close, he killed it with his sharp axe. When the Wicked Witch saw what the Tin Man had done, she became even angrier. So she blew her silver whistle twice. In a few minutes, a great flock of wild crows came flying towards her. The Wicked Witch said to the King Crow,
Fly at once to the strangers and pick out their eyes and tear them to pieces.
The wild crows flew toward Dorothy and her friends. The Scarecrow said,
This is my battle. Lie down beside me and you will be safe.
So everyone lay down on the ground. The Scarecrow stood up and stretched out his arms. When the crows saw him, they were frightened and did not dare to come any closer. But the King Crow said,
It is only a stuffed man. I will pick his eyes out.
The King Crow flew at the Scarecrow, who caught it by the head and twisted its neck until it was dead. As each crow flew at the Scarecrow, he twisted its neck. When the Wicked Witch saw all her crows lying in a heap, she went into a terrible rage and blew her silver whistle three times. This time, a swarm of bees came flying to her. The Wicked Witch told the bees to sting Dorothy and her friends to death. But the Scarecrow saw the bees coming. He scattered his straw over Dorothy, Toto, and the lion. This way, the bees flew at the Tin Man, and their stingers broke off against the tin, and all the bees died.